what separates the fossilized plants from, I imagine everything doesn't get fossilized. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So here's the key thing that you have to know about fossils is that in order to become a fossil, you've got to die and you got to get buried.
Okay.
Right? And if you don't get buried, say you just fall over in the forest somewhere, you're going to rot away. It's death plus burial. So if you're a dinosaur, you fall over and you die, chances are you're not going to become a fossil unless you live in a place where stuff gets buried. And what are those places? There are places like Louisiana, for instance. Right? If you Louisiana, the whole landscape is sinking slowly, and the stream is always dumping out sediment and putting more layers on it. So in an area that's sinking is what I call D-world or deposition world.
Right.
And if you were to drill a hole beneath New Orleans, you would go down almost 20,000 feet in layered mud that's only 25 million years old.
What?
That's literally miles of thickness.
Yes.
It's miles. So if a fish died in New Orleans 10 million years ago, it would be 10,000 feet down.
Wow.
And in the sediment it was buried in is being compacted into rock.
So I've seen this this image geologically of the Gulf of Mexico and how it goes out underwater. Then there's like this big giant cliff.
Yep.
So all of that stuff is from the river?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, and from rivers dating back to millions of years. So the earth is, as it erodes mountain ranges, all the sediment ground up mountain ranges end up at the edge of the continents and piling up in thick layers of sediment or limestone or other kinds of stuff. And that's where you create the fossils. An animal dies or animal plant dies, is buried in an area that's sinking, which buries it deeply, and that turns the sediment into rock.
Yes.
And there at depth. And then eventually what happens is some other first phenomenon pushes that area back up. So areas that were depositional areas or D-world become lifted up into what is called E-world or erosion world. So if you can look at North America, for instance, most of North America right now is erosion world or E-world.
It's getting eroded away.
You know, there's mountains. Anytime you see a hill or a mountain, you know that stuff's eroding away. Look at the Mississippi River.
Anytime you see a river, right?
Yeah,
river,
exactly. Yeah. Some areas, and so there are think about this. There are rivers in erosion world, like the Colorado River is cutting the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
Not a good place to become a fossil. That's just grinding away and taking it out to the sea.
And it goes side to side and meanders. Yeah. And
but that same river, like Mississippi, when it gets down to New Orleans, great place to make a fossil. So that's the E world, D world difference. And the best place to find fossils, and like maybe the best place in the world to find fossils, is Western United States, because most of the last 500 million years, that landscape was sinking. It was D-world. But then when the uplift of the Rocky Mountains started, it pushed that area back up and exposed those rocks in E-world. So you want D-world.
So you bury them.
Bury them.
Then lift them
and
erode the stuff off the top of them, and now they're exposed.
Exactly. And sometimes you uplift them in an irregular way. So in one place, you might be able to see a cross-section of the entire stack. And there's a place near Cody, Wyoming, where you can see from 2.5 billion years to 60 million years in one spot.
Jeez.
It's better than the Grand Canyon.
That is... And so because they've been lifted and turned now, it's more horizontal or at an angle rather than
vertical. Exactly. It used to be flat and then turned up and they're almost vertical and you just count the pages like this all the way through.
Wow. And each layer has its representative fossils.
Exactly. There, like always, there's sort of local D world, like the immediate area around you. Like you're standing next to a mud bluff and it slumps down and buries you.
Right.
You just got buried in a little narrow piece of D world.
I see.
But if you want to look at it at the continental scale, there most of North America is E world, but there are little local ponds and little local lakes.
Yeah.
But those local things are not going to get preserved. They'll eventually fill up and erode away too. So the fossils are going to be in those places where the whole landscape is sinking.
Whole landscape. So what places would that be on Earth today?
The edges of the continents primarily, the shallow, low elevation parts of the margins of the continents.
Okay. Is that generally true throughout history?
Yeah. So as a result, we really don't have much of a fossil record for mountains or hills.
Wow. So for example, right now, humans are distributed primarily along coastlines.
Yep.
So would it be the case that land animals, even though it's geographically limited, it's still a good representation because that's where most life is going to concentrate anyway? Is that fair?
It's true. That's probably the case. But like, you know, you're still going to miss the mountain goats and stuff like that, right?
Right, so right.
You're gonna,
they still
it's
exist.
Things that live only at high elevations or, you know, even on the Great Plains, some of those things do get preserved. Like the animals of the Great Plains are preserved because the Rocky Mountains came up and all the sediment coming off the Rocky Mountains shed and buried things under river sediments.
Right.
And then that area is still coming up, so those river sediments are now being exposed.
Oh.
And so you have that kind of local D-world is a source of good fossils on continents. And we found an amazing site in Colorado in 2012 that was a lake on top of a hill at 9,000 feet.
Whoa.
And it filled up with
Lake Tahoe. No.
No, it's at Snowmass Ski Area.
It's
700 yards from the base of the ski area. There's a little 12-acre lake that turned out to have been an ice age lake that filled up between 120,000 years ago and 50,000 years ago. And we found 50 mastodons and 12 mammoths in this one little lake in 70 days of digging. It was an amazing thing. But that was a little tiny lake on top of a hill that was a little temporary bit of D-world.
Yeah.
And in the future, that'll erode away and go away. But we got it before it eroded away.
Wow.
We were just our timing was very good.
Good timing. Yeah. But over geological history, a lot of those have come and gone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Because that's at the top of the hill. It's going to go.
Right. It's going to
go. Hills go away. Mountains go away.
They're temporary.
Yeah. Never trust mountain ranges. They're undependable. They erode away.
All right. You can't depend on them.
Yeah.